Hello everyone, I'm Castrense Savoiardo from the Biocomputing Group, University of Bologna, and in this poster I'm presenting the results of a study entitled Physicochemical and Structural Features of Pathogenic and Benign Human Protein Missense Variations collected from Yunsavar and Klimbar. The widespread adoption of sequencing technologies provides a huge amount of data about missense single nucleotide variations, leading often to observable changes in protein sequences. For many of these variations, links to diseases are also reported in public databases. Here we consider two large datasets of single residue variations extracted from Yunsavar and Klimbar, with the aim of characterizing differences among pathogenic and benign variants in terms of physicochemical and structural features. In particular, we generated a dataset of germline variations collected from Yunsavar, the UniProt dataset of human missense variants, and Klimbar, the NCBI resource of relationships among human variations and disease phenotypes. Variations were collected with the annotation of their effect on human health, as reported in the two databases. Here, two classes of variations are considered. So, variations that are labeled as likely pathogenic or pathogenic, and variations labeled as likely benign or benign. All the variations with uncertain significance were discarded from this analysis. Furthermore, benign variations were collected only when they are reported in the same genes where also disease-related variations are reported. In this scenario, the harmonization of disease definition is an issue for a better association of molecular events to phenotypes. In this respect, we adopted here the Mondo disease ontology, which integrates also resources like COMIM, and we retained only pathogenic variations that are clearly linked to Mondo diseases. In this table, we summarize the composition of the Yunsavar and Klimbar datasets, as well as the consistency of their intersection and union. Overall, the union dataset collects more than 75,000 variations coming from 3,605 proteins. Some 58% of all the variations is pathogenic. It is also important to notice that Yunsavar and Klimbar provide different and complementary single residue variation sets, in particular for what concerns the benign class. Indeed, the two datasets share only about 14 and 28% of the benign and pathogenic variations, respectively, and 71% of the genes collected in a union dataset. We then started analyzing our data in terms of physicochemical and structural features. Taking advantage of computational methods, we predicted protein solvent accessibility, protein flexibility and disorder for positions carrying pathogenic and benign variations. And we then compared results obtained on the Klimbar, the Yunsavar and the Union datasets to highlight if any difference is present in terms of this feature. For computing the protein flexibility, we used here a predictor called Medusa that has been recently released. Starting from protein sequence, Medusa assigns to residues five levels of flexibility that we reduced here into two classes. The rigid class, which merges flexibility levels 0 and 1, and the flexible class, merging flexibility levels 2, 3, and 4. The distribution of variations according to flexibility shows that pathogenic variations more often occur in rigid positions, while benign variations are more frequent in flexible regions. Interestingly, this is true rather independently of the dataset considered, as shown in these distributions. Going a step forward in our analysis, we characterize also residue solvent accessibility for all the sequences in our dataset using an in-house predictor based on deep learning. Our results show that pathogenic variations are significantly more abundant in varied regions, about the 75% of all pathogenic variations, while benign variations occur preferentially in solvent-exposed regions, about the 60%. These findings confirm what we observed in previous studies on a smaller dataset that was derived from Yunsavar only, and this tendency here is conserved and confirmed also for Klimbar and the Union datasets. Finally, intrinsically disordered regions were extracted from the MobiDB database, collecting annotations for protein disorder and mobility. The analysis of IDP regions is clearly biased by the uneven background distribution, not shown here, according to which only 14% of disordered residues are predicted in the whole protein sequences. In spite of this, we observe a slight tendency of pathogenic variations to be more abundant in structured, not disordered regions than benign variations. Interestingly, again, all these conclusions are rather independent of the considered dataset. In conclusion, we investigated here the association between variants and diseases. Our analysis shows that pathogenic and benign variations are endowed with distinctive features, and these differences are similar across the analyzed datasets. Overall, the findings suggest that single residue variations deriving from Yun-Savar and Klein-Barr, despite their limited overlap, share common physicochemical and structural features and can be then surfacely merged, enabling more comprehensive and significant analysis. Possibly, new incoming data will be framed into our basic representation and will allow a better understanding of the mechanisms connecting specific phenotypes linked to germline variations. That's all. I'd like to thank other members of my group and, of course, you for the kind attention. Thank you very much.